Hello, and welcome to a short Havoc Sons adventure video. I like saying adventure video, even when there's no real adventure, like today. No real adventure. But I did pick up something kind of cool. This is a realistic SA-10 solid state stereo amplifier. I have several of these, but not one as old as this. Also, I was surprised to see the output. Can you see that there? Your output is 1 watt with a 10% total harmonic distortion. So, not the cleanest little amplifier, nor the most powerful, but it is moving at 8 to 16 ohms instead of most stereos. Cheap sound systems today are working at 4 ohm capacities. So it's got the LGR approved wood grain finish. And then let's see if I can bring this over to the back. If I pull this one out here for a sec, there we go. You see it has plugs for phono. That's kind of cool. And then taper tuner, and then your speakers out. Now, I acquired, I don't know, if I see a set of wood grain, anything, Radio Shack speakers, I pick them up. So I got these a little while ago. Now what these are the Optimus KTS-25s. What they look like, KTS-25. And then the back, again, not real powerful, 10 watts max, but don't let that disturb you because input is 8 ohms. Which, if you're basically what that just means is if you're running a normal speakers, they're usually speakers today are set up at 4 ohms, so you just double the capacity. So if you have a receiver that's outputting, let's say 25 watts at 4 ohms, or 20 watts at 4 ohms, you could actually run a 10 watt, 8 ohm speaker, and it would handle it, which this one would. So that's, you just basically double the watts if you're going down on, if you're increasing the ohms. So, how about those? And then, I also got these. Now, you can see that these are full-range drivers, and I don't know, I think that's 3-inch, and I don't know, maybe 2-inch or 2.5-inch. Like I said, this one here is 10 watts at 8 ohms, and then this one here is a whopping 7 watts at 8 ohms. But, you know, again, walking by a thrift store, saw them, had to get them, don't know why. Just LGR approved wood grain, that's it. I mean, believe me, I was into wood grain before he was even born. That's for another story. He just is one of the few people out there that has let everyone else know how cool it is. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm going to play some music. Can't play it long because, you know, everybody gets all upset. And what I'm gonna do is move from, and of course they come twice every month, and of course they came today. My lawnmower guy. So you're probably gonna hear him in the background. I apologize. I mean, if I was more into these, recording these videos perfectly, because I tell you, I'm out in the country now, and there's just no noise. I mean, we're talking about no sound at all. But now we got this guy. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to play this. Now, what I'm going to do here is I'm going to play this, and I'm going to show you the difference in sound. I'm definitely going to go with those. Oh, God, stop. Basically you have the phono switch, which we're not going to use, or the tape tuner. Then you have mono or stereo, and then you have tone. To the right is more bass, to the left is more treble, and then you have independent, which is kind of cool, independent sound from each speaker. So I'm going to turn these on and go ahead and play a little bit of Jessica from the Allman Brothers. What I'm going to do. Okay, just set it up to make sure it's good. So first we're going to hear the right speaker. I mean, it's trying, it's full range, but you can tell it's kind of has a muffled bass effect. And now the left speaker. And back to the right one. Now the left one. Okay, so right away, I can tell that the speaker to the left, what is that, the XTS-25s are, they're giving me a little bit better highs. And I kind of like that sound. I mean, they're not great, but their highs are a little bit better. Oh yeah, yeah, quite a bit. Yeah, there is a bit of a difference. I mean, look, they're little speakers. They're not going to sound fantastic, but there's definitely a little bit of a difference. That one has a little bit better volume. So the XTS-25s went out, but I don't know. I still may not run them because I just love the compact size of these against the... Well, this one doesn't really have a model number. It just, well, it, unless it's Minimus. Yeah, I think that's a model number. Minimus 0.3. Wow, what a name. Catalog is 40-1250C. I don't know if these are shielded. Boy, they feel heavy, though, that like they might be. These are shielded, so there's no magnetic interference. So anyway, this is my little video on a little sound system. I wanted to, I have a real elaborate sound system for my computer. It's a surround sound 5.1 by Logitech, but it's still in storage and I'm going through my storage. So I just grabbed this up real quick just to get something going. Now, I bought this. You can get these really cheap. I think I paid $14 for two of them. So what I did was I'm going to put some of this tape, and I'm going to just stick it down in here so that I can, so it won't move and I can control it. So anyway, that's the setup. Can you see the other speaker? Let's see if you can see it. Yeah. See it okay. So that's it. Quick little video on my SA10 solid state amplifier, a whopping 1 amp. Powerful. Running, and I guess I'm going to go with my XTS-25, my shielded, because they sound a little better. Plus, they're magnetically shielded. Not that I don't think I'm going to have anything to worry about over here. So that's pretty much it. Something I picked up at, I think I got this on the internet. So many different things happening lately, I forget. But anyway, I saw it, I picked it up. Official LGR wood grain. There's newer models, which I have the newer model of this too, but that's in storage. But I love this one because it's got black accents with chrome. It's just that whole 60s look. All right, well, thanks for watching. Have a great day and a better life. Remember, do more of what makes you happy. See ya.